Hello everyone and welcome to Lot of Tech once again. So in today's video, we'll be reviewing these Sony Wireless XP400 extra bass earphones. So let's start with the box and packaging. So the box says that these earphones come with a battery life of 15 hours. They have a Bluetooth 5.0 connectivity. You get the extra bass table on the box and also the Sony hologram right on the top of the box. Another side of the box says that these are extra bass earphones, which we will check later in the video. And the box and the back side of the box mentions some information about the controls and functions. And there is another side of the box which says that these earphones have a price of around 4,990, but I got these for 2,990 and the price is always around 3,000 depending upon deals and discount. So the box is sealed from top and bottom, and when you are going to remove the seal, it's going to leave some kind of mark on the box which will help you figure out if the unit is entirely new or it has been opened before. So when you will take out the unit, what you will get inside is a small user manual, and then in the compartment below you will find another big user manual, two extra pair of ear tips and a type C cable. It's good to see that most of the earphones these days are coming with a type C cable. So the one that I'm having is a blue color, and there are few more color options available. And also these earphones are magnetic, and it's the first time I'm looking at any Sony earphone that is coming with entirely flat cable. So these earphones are made completely out of plastic, and you get Sony branding on each earbud, and also each earbud is marked in conventional Sony style for left and right. Like left one is marked with a white color and right one is marked with a red color. Both these earphones are very small and compact, and you don't feel any kind of pain while using them. And also both these earbuds have some kind of rubber coating on them to provide you with a better grip. As I said before, these earphones are magnetic, and also when you will have a closer look at each earbud, then you will find that the finishing of these earphones is not that perfect. I mean, the finishing is good, or you can say average, but these earphones definitely can't be called premium when you compare them with Sony EX255 or 155, the wired ones which I had earlier. I'll not say the earphones are bad looking ones, but they definitely don't carry that premium Sony vibe for which the company is known for. I think this is the place where most of the cost cutting has been done to make these earphones more affordable. During my testing, I removed one of the silicone ear tips from one of the earbuds and found that there wasn't any sort of protective mesh. Then I removed the silicone ear tip from the other one as well, and I found that there isn't any kind of protective mesh on these earbuds, which was quite surprising for me. And then I went back to the user manual and found that these earphones does not have any kind of IP rating. So make sure that you don't spill water on them and handle them with care. As I said before, the earphones have completely flat cables, and with the left earbud you will find your controls. So the controls are quite soft and very easy to handle. I didn't find any sort of difficulty while pressing the buttons or anything. The buttons are very soft and very tactile, and also you will find your Type-C port. So you can charge these earphones with any 5 volt supply. Don't connect any sort of very high wattage charger because it may or damage the circuit. So make sure that you connect it to a laptop or a PC to charge them. If I talk about the connectivity or the pairing process, so it's completely hassle free. Just turn on the Bluetooth on your phone and press the power button on the earphone for a couple of seconds. A blue LED will be blinking and the earphones will be connecting in a couple of seconds. If you want to disconnect, then you have to once again press the power button on the earphone and it will take a couple of seconds to disconnect. Now connecting these earphones to your smartphones takes a couple of seconds, but disconnecting is almost instantaneous. If you are in any music player application, then you can use the power button on the earphone to play and pause a song. If you want to go to the next track, then press and hold the volume up button until the track changes. And if you want to come back to the previous track, then press and hold the volume down button until the track changes. If you want to bring up the volume slider, then just press volume up or down button once. It will bring up the volume slider, and from here you can control your volume. These controls not only work with your music player application, but also if you are watching any video on YouTube, then the functions remains the same. Like you can press the power button to play and pause the track, and also you can press and hold the volume up button to go to the next track, and same thing goes with the volume down button to go back to the previous track.
If you want to know about the audio quality, so this is the kind of audio that you will be getting when you have connected these to your smartphone, and this is the kind of volume that you will be getting if it is very close to your mouth, and this is the kind of volume that you would be getting if your microphone is slightly away from your mouth. Do let me know what you think in the comment section below.
So before moving ahead, I first of all want to give you a small update on these Bolt Audio Airbase Truebuds, which I reviewed in the last video. Many of you have asked me about the battery backup. So first of all, I charged these on 25th or I think 26th of January, and they got completely discharged on 11th of Feb. So for me, as per my usage pattern, the battery backup was straight 15 days. And initially I was using them extensively, but later on I used it moderately, and sometimes I didn't even use it for a couple of days. But overall the battery backup is 15 days for me, Even if you are a heavy user, I'll still say that the battery backup will be somewhere around 8 to 10 days depending on your usage pattern. I think it is more than sufficient. One of you have also asked me what is the battery backup of the earbud alone, like you don't put it back in the case, and how many hours you can use it straight. So I just want to tell you that I watched a movie for 2 hours straight and battery backup got reduced from 100 to 70%. So with the remaining 70%, you can still use it for, I think, 3 hours. And not to push it to, but 3 hours. So straight 5 to 6 hours of backup without putting them back in the case. And it's not good for your ears to use any earphone or a earbud for such a long time. Give a break to yourself, put it back in the case and don't use it too much. So as far as the battery backup goes, I don't think anyone is going to have complaint with these. And now let's talk about the XP400. So these earphones are first of all extra bass earphones. And when I say extra bass, another thing that comes to your mind is the XB55AP, which are also extra bass earphones. So you can say that these earphones are kind of wireless variant of the XB55. You invest 700 rupees more in XB55 and you get the wireless variant of XB55, which is XB400. But still, there is some kind of difference in the bass between the two, which I'll talk in detail in the comparison video. But overall, the bass is quite good. It's very solid, very punchy bass. It's not a humming bass that's going to give you a headache, just like the Bolt Audio Airbase 2 Watts. And I'm saying they are going to give you a headache, but still, like, it's a humming bass, it's a punchy bass. If I talk about the treble, so if you ever had any Sony earphone in the past, then the treble or the voice clarity is same as you would expect with the Sony. Crystal clear audio, good separation between vocals and background music, and the stereo is also quite good. Now, when it comes to stereo, another thing that comes to your mind is the EX255AB, which were stereo earphones. Now, EX255 are stereo earphones, XB55 is the extra bass earphone, and this earphone has both of these words written on the box, like the stereo earphones and extra bass earphones. So you can say it's kind of a mix between the EX255 and XB55, and they lie somewhere in between. I'd also make a dedicated comparison video between all of these, so that will give you a better idea. But overall, stereo is quite good, but not as good as the EX255. Overall, if you want to use these earphones for gaming, then I would say that for casual gaming, they are good. I don't play too many games, but still I didn't notice any sort of latency issues, especially in PUBG. But yeah, if you are a professional and a hardcore gamer, then you would definitely go with the wired variant. Don't never go with the wireless earphones when it comes to gaming, because you will come across some kind of minor latency issues somewhere or the other. If you want to use it for recording purposes, for calling and everything, these are the ones that you can go for. So overall, the conclusion here is that at a price of 2,990, Sony has really cut down the prices. And the only thing that you compromise little bit on these is the build quality and the overall build material. But when it comes to sound quality, these are really very nice, and you can go with this at a price of around 3,000. So thank you so much for watching the video. I'll see you in the next one. Take care.